Hello all, this is Jim Johnson, aka Sulfur Blade, and I am back here with the Political Process, a game I have been very much deeply involved in since discovering it on Steam. If you are not at least 13 years of age, this video is not intended for you. Please stop watching. Alright, with that quick disclaimer out of the way, let's actually jump into the meat and potatoes of the video. I believe we're beginning our fourth term as 7th District Congressman in Wisconsin. And we're probably making good strides to possibly make it to becoming Speaker of the House. Or do we want to shift things up? I've been thinking about shifting things up because I want to see how the gameplay is from some different perspectives besides the House. However, at the same time, I would like to get to Speaker and know what that's like. So I'm thinking I should probably push for Speaker. And I've just noticed that, holy cats, my name recognition is way higher than the 890-some thousand it was before. Why has my name recognition gone up into the millions all of a sudden? Yeah, 868,000. What is this? I'm confused here. All right, I'm not going to try to figure that out. If I do a few turns, maybe it'll go back down to the 800,000 point, or maybe I am actually that highly recognized. Okay, so these state laws are taking effect. The national law is taking into effect. And what was our Congress and Senate looking like right now? We are majority House. We are not the majority Senate. And we, of course, are not president. So we have the House and that's it. I didn't have any promises this campaign, so nothing. No legislation I have to try to pass for sure. Though I'm still trying to reduce the deficit. Okay, vote on budget resolution. A higher education grants. Even if I tried to repeal it, I wouldn't be successful. I'd get it through the House. It probably wouldn't get through the Senate, or it might get through the Senate, but it would get vetoed by the President over and over again. So there's no way to get around the veto in this game. So right now, with a Democrat president, there's probably no point in even trying to do legislation unless the Dems might appreciate the legislation. It's something like a tax raise, for instance. Alright, floor debate. Social Security, message from party leader, support HR. Message from caucus leader, support HR. Amend hearing. So this is probably a shadow. Yep, trying to change it from 66 to 69. Of course, the president opposes it. We will support it. It will go to the Senate, where it might get through, and then it'll be vetoed. Defense appropriations. Yep, I will try to decrease this impossible to decrease statistic. And, as always, denied. Of course, this one I can cut without any issues. So let's do that. Commerce, justice, yeah, this one can be amended too. Oh, what did I just do? Somebody put an amendment on it. I couldn't even amend it. That's terrible. Possible to amend one. Transportation, housing. Isn't this the one I didn't get to change? What is this? What just happened? I don't even know if my thing went through or not. cannabis legality. We got one support and one oppose HR 17, with the speaker, the more conservative Republican, agreeing with the president. What is this? You know, I'm trying to get rid of power coming from polluting sources anyway by promoting alternate energy sources, so sure. Holy cats, look at that proposal. I didn't expect that to happen. It's the big forehead man. He's back. Senator Cletus Fulton will not seek re-election. Who is that? This list is terrible. They're like, I don't know, it doesn't seem like there's any rhyme or reason. Cleus Fulton, Democrat, Wisconsin. Okay. What is his term party? Da-da-da. Should I try to come after Cletus Fulton? Something to ponder. Maybe I'll send one of my protégés after. Can I do that? I can't tell them what to do right now. Okay, so I'm just gonna continue on as a senator, I think. Okay, national law is taking effect this year. National law S8, legality of cannabis. Marijuana legalizes the sale of cannabis. Marijuana legalizes the possession of cannabis. Marijuana. City, state, and federal departments have updated their annual reports. Blah, 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 blah. Now, can we pass legislation to tax the hell out of cannabis? That'll get us up to 1 billion, huh? ~30% seems reasonable. Your bill, H.R. 1, has been assigned to the House Ways and Means Committee. Chairperson Trevor Erickson has granted your bill a hearing. Your experience and political reputation have influenced the vote of 20 politicians and changed the vote of 16. Your legislation, H.R. 1, has made it out of committee with a vote of 36-3. We're well on our way of collecting that tax income from marijuana. All right, let's start the campaign process. Alright, we got the people upgraded we need upgraded. Do our 3 rallies. Do our fundraiser. Remind Democrats that I exist. And Democrats and everyone love my stance on Social Security. I've done all my jobs in the house, yes. Alright, you currently have Florida Bates cannabis sales tax. The proposed tax rate is too high. I urge my colleagues to vote no on this bill. Seriously? Do you really care we're about to make a bunch of money off people smoking pot? Look at that support. It's off the charts. And Big Foreheads guy says, I really appreciate all the ideas I'm hearing about the environment. Climate change is not real. I don't believe that efforts to combat climate change are necessary. Opponents. No Republican opponents. Good. It's a good thing. A very good thing. Senate Finance Committee granted Bill a hearing. Your experience in vote of five politicians. Your legislation HR1 made it out of committee with a solid vote. Good. Watch the Republican. Nah, screw the primaries. Approved by the Senate. President Wayne Carey has signed your bill into law. Woohoo! Yeah! Alcohol tax, support and support. You know, I haven't been adjusting the volunteers at all much. That's better. Wish it would save this setting every year. I keep forgetting to set this. It's a good thing I'm an incumbent and I have all the money in the world for ads. So, even though I'm not actually having to win the primary, I'm an incumbent, so I'm going to automatically win. I'm going to release a big ad just to take the steam out of the Democrats before their primary election, to remind them that their doom is imminent. And we'll do it with our hallmark Social Security topic. Keith Gray beats out Rachel Whitaker. Rally with presidential nominee Rich Shen. Cool. That's the guy that looks like, what's his name? Wow, what's wrong with me? I'll think of it in a second. $500 political points, your influence in public opinion, blah 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 blah, sweet. My brain just doesn't work the way it used to. I can't think of this guy's name. Ben Shapiro. He reminds me of Ben Shapiro, that guy I just did the fundraiser with. Alright, committee amendment, defense appropriations. I'm not even gonna bother. You're bringing it down, decreasing. I'll vote for it. Though it's pointless. You're bringing it down. I'll vote for it. But it's pointless. I'm gonna do something a little different here, I think. Small ad, just to be different. Rally with the governor. Sweet. Get me those sweet political points. Commerce. Time to gut commerce. How many years will it take me to get to zero on these bars? Wait, I thought I gutted commerce. What's going on here? Somebody trying to ungut commerce? Now it's Homeland's turn. Let's do another clean energy ad. Television. Amendment. No, I don't support this amendment. Rally with the good old governor. Evidently, I have to remind these people about my economic policies, because they're starting to go in the wrong direction. So So. Go general. This is gonna bring down some opinion. I know that's gonna happen. But at the same time, it's like putting an unpopular message out there. If this is gonna work, I'm gonna have to beat the horn a few times to get the opinion to swing back in my favor. And there it drops, right? Labor, health, and human. Yeah, this is the one that can't be changed. Now you see how these are going back into the blue? My message is starting to affect the public opinion. Even though it lowered a lot of my voting enthusiasm to do that. So whether or not this was the greatest idea in the long run is yet to be seen, but I wanted to counteract that red trend that was forming here on economy. Now I can probably go back to my bread and butter social security thing to get the blue bar back up real quick, I think. And back up we go. Not as fast, though, but it is progress. Hey, back with Richard Chen again. rallying with the governor again. Back with Richard Shen again, woohoo. We're gonna pull out a secret marketing weapon here. We're gonna specifically target minimum wage and marketing because everybody loves my minimum wage stand. Did that counteract? Yep, that did counteract it a little bit. Not just in the general election, but every election, blah 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 blah. Hey, Richard Shen, there's my man. I believe I'm the best candidate for the presidency. I hope you will support me in the upcoming election. Kind of a Ben Shapiro. Put a little, what is that, that little hat that he wears on there? Okay, so what is it I'm wanting to do this turn? We are 6 weeks from the election. Probably just turn it. Fundraiser with the governor. Getting me those wonderful political points. I love these governors and presidents. Remind people I'm the minimum wage king. An understanding of where we've been and where we can go is essentially in planning a path. Is essential in planning a path for the future. I have a plan that I believe will put our nation on a successful path for the future. I will improve education, reduce poverty, and improve healthcare. So you're going to spend money. Like every Democrat, you're going to spend lots of money. Good job. If I'm elected president, I intend to address major issues facing this country. I will strengthen our military, spending more money. Improve the budget. If you mean pay down the budget, that's good. And improve the economy. Well, if you pay down the budget, you will improve the economy. Budget deficit, whatever. You guys know what I meant. Remind people about our immigration stances. I, of course, advocate for the modernist principles of compromise. the end of this turn, so I gotta do my big add. Minimum wage. For days. And now, I have a feeling that this particular election is going to be a little closer than previous ones. No, pretty much same 60-40. In fact, it's probably a little bit more 60-40 than usual. I like it when I'm wrong. Congratulations on winning the election. You did a great job. Your fifth term will begin the first week of the year. All information and responsibilities related to your new office can be found in the office tab. Good luck. Do you want to watch the presidential election? Why? Yeah, I actually kind of do. Come on, Rich. Come on, Rich. You can do it, Rich. Hey, we got West Virginia, which is better than we've done lately. Come on, more red, more red. Missouri. Ugh. Come on, get Wisconsin and Iowa. Damn it. Got Iowa. That's California. More red than usual, but not enough red. Rich, you did better than some Republicans have this game so far, but you didn't do good enough. And we're stuck with another Democrat at president. Starting to feel like this game is a little bit rigged towards the Democrats at this point. None of you guys won, did you? No Thanksgiving parade for me this year. Welcome to your fifth term as U.S. House of Representative member. You have been selected as Vice Chairperson of the Moderate Republican Caucus. As Vice Chair, any legislation that you write will be supported by all caucus members, so long as you have a good relationship with the group. Excellent. Well, we might as well be committee chair of Appropriations Committee. Maybe I'll finally be able to balance those impossible to balance budget sections this way. National laws taking effect this year. National law HR1. Miscellaneous law. What the hell's that? I don't remember a miscellaneous law. What is miscellaneous law? I have no idea what that is. Maybe it was my marijuana tax. Miscellaneous. Yeah, that could be it. Welcome to your new term as member of Congress. I'm glad you're part of our caucus. Blah, 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 blah. Yes, I'm your vice chair or whatever. Party leadership. Yep, what's up? Would you guys retire already? Actually, while we're at it. Senate. More Democrat. Yuck. We are more Republican in the House, though. That's good. But we don't have the presidency. Rankings. There we are. We're number 5 right now in the House. Alright, let's get back to the office and get to work. Vote on budget resolution. There we go. Nice amendment. Oh, almost. Man, that was a close one. My name recognition is heading off the charts here. Florida bait, alcohol tax, support. Create appropriate bill defense. Oh my god, am I gonna actually be able to... increase spending from... What?! What?! Increase spending from 339 billion to 617 billion? You're flipping nuts. Are you kidding me right now? Oh my god. I get the ability to finally write it, and this happens? Alright, the defense funding is just ridiculous. Redonkulous. This is flippin' ludicrous. Wait, did I just vote the wrong way? Well, it doesn't matter if I would have supported it. Decrease spending. The amendment proposal was to decrease. Education, health, and labor. Maybe I can neuter this one enough to make up for the defense. I'm never gonna freaking get the deficit down. Never. The question is, was that... So that's... This is million, so this is the billion line. So that was an increase of about 2 billion. But I neutered it more than 2 billion, right? So in the end, I think I won on that one. Oh, this is paying us, huh? I think we need to cut our pay in half, because we're crappy congressmen. If we're going to double the defense budget to record highs ever seen, then we deserve to take it out of our own pockets. Trying to increase it again, you bastards! Agency budget request. Last year's budget was 2724. Well, I can't go any higher than that, huh? So you bring up minimum wage, trying to lower it, and what happens? It goes up. So maybe you shouldn't try to press the issue in the future while I'm head of this committee. I'm curious. The hell does my budget look like this year after frickin' the craziness that happened with military spending? That's 20. I don't think I'm going to see it. It's not going to translate until next year, I don't think. Barney Weiss has retired, huh? That hasn't clicked over yet, I don't think. Yeah. Look at that. That's just insanity, and that's because of the military section. Yep, military went whoop, as everything else kind of went down. So, this is probably a good place to end this particular episode. I'm so frustrated with the, I don't know, the game purposely screwing over the budget. I mean, seriously, that's the way it feels. Before, I could only affect those basically three budget categories to make any trimming of the fat. Now that I was the chairman of the big committee, I could actually write the laws. But then they turn around and with an amendment, literally double defense spending. That and it approves? It's like insanity. Complete insanity. Ah, very frustrating. I thought for once I would finally be able to actually make some progress, and then that. Ah! Are you kidding me? Really? Anyway, I'm James Johnson, aka Sulfur Blade. This is my content. Hopefully you're enjoying it. If so, please leave a like and subscribe. Until the next time, all. Peace.